Sandra Status, waiting for something to happen. Steaming off critters. She Status, making dust drawings. Chatting with Hedwyn. Chatting with Rookie. Well, at least it's consistent. Doing some cleaning. Find everyone is feeling rather miserable. You sense just by being the flagging hands eats away at one's spirits. Only the imp Tizu seems unaffected. Most of your fellow exiles lost a hope. Well, that's nice.
Tintapelus.
A moment, reader. There are several courses we may take through the flagging hands. If you choose to prolong your stay, it may be worth your while. However, your companion's spirits shall likely suffer more. South Road through the flagging hands crosses diseased and wilted plains. Mill Road through the flagging hands cuts straight to the pit of. I would suggest taking this faster road to reduce your companion's loss of hope. Mass grave. Valuable item. Curious about the item. Stop right in the middle of that. North Road through Flaggy Hands is dismal beyond reckoning. There is little talk among your group, yet you sense despair encroaching. Only Tizo seems unaffected. Later, you accompany the lone minstrel in pursuit of his task here. Speak not directly to the living shade, and be true to your heart when responding to its inquiries, and make no attempt to look it in the eye. The lone minstrel offers these and other words of advice as you approach the burial mounds of Coldmount, where many exiles of the downside see their final days. The thorough burning failed to cleanse a certain haunted air here. A glimmer of a shade appears before you, stand surrounded by the dead. You barely see it, and it does not speak, but you feel its thoughts piercing your heart and mind. According to the shade, the book that you possess may lay some of the fallen here to rest. The shade leaves you to your work. You turn through the book, locating passages concerning freedom and spirit. You recite such words as seem best fit to each of the fallen you see. It's draining work. The shade resurfaces after a while, leads you to a hollowed stump, and then fades away. I found a shroom. By the time you reach the pit of Milith, everyone besides the imp Tizo seems to be feeling even worse than before. You sense their desire to leave this place as soon as possible. Oh god. Prepare for the ride anyway. You mad about it? Hey. You sense Jorrael's steel gaze well before you turn to her. Reader, rummaging about the wagon once again. Tell me something, now that you're here.
Eratamero.
Look at me. Are you afraid of me? Not particularly. Consider the question. You've never before met someone like her, but you do know something of what happens to those who remain on the downside for many years. You tell her that, although you do not know each other very well, you do not fear her, and on the contrary, feel safer in her presence.
Tace.
Truly?
Potem bravare.
In that case, I have much work left to do. You shall fear me yet, if you survive this place. Now then, I shall go make my rounds. She walks away. You feel the floor of the wagon shake with her step. But she can't hope. My dog wants to come inside. He's gonna bark. He's making lead-up bark noises. It was not long before the Empire began to crumble. With my liege gone, his own country quickly turned upon itself. I must admit that this collapse had started long before the Emperor's disappearance. His decision to give chase after a myth but hastened the inevitable. All the while, the rope collar stood by, awaiting such a time as he could rule in my liege's stead. He would be our people's savior. His first charge was to organize a search for the missing Solium Mur. Warriors, pathfinders, and scholars heard the call and prepared to seek him out. Sparkly. What's that? Sniffing the book. He is not. Saluting the scribes. It's all creaky. Hi guys, you know this place, a lot of folks, but not a lot of customers, know what I mean? So have a look around. Ooh. Scribe rock. But I can sell this. The Hope Stone would actually be quite handy, since everybody's just decimated. Meow. My dog is sad.
Poppy, Vicky, Tuesday.
They're leaving, Dad. Just look at how much we got this time. I think I can adjust it in the actual rates, but his hope is he's just got no hope. Oh, it does do that. You just need to get it up high enough. My dog is very sad. Extra hope. I'm gonna do one more right, and then I'm probably gonna take a break. Or even sleep, because I'm very tired. And I got work tomorrow. As you make preparations for the coming raid, you wonder if the stars above will even be visible through the dense fog hanging over the pit of Milith. Then, angriness. He's very concerned. Little imp disappears in a hurry. Oh, is Tizo alright? He was so frightened. He was not frightened. He was issuing a warning.
Siddhanta!
Silence, everyone. Take cover. Toad Ral makes a quick note of several hiding places among the nearby crags and rotted husks. Ugh. You wait. Something about this place dampens your senses. All you feel is a creeping dread. Then, from the shadows, a writhing shape slides forward, its hulking form draped in raiments. The shape stops slowly, its head turns from one of you to the next, each in turn. Why is it you to hide yourselves from us, little nightwings? Ye trespass on the resting place of the Astralborn. We shall see ye when the stars muster the courage to illuminate this place. The creature vanishes into the dark. After a time, your companions reconvene. That was a bog crone. Indeed, that was Witch Edmilhi of the Withdrawn. Although the rites dictate she cannot harm you bodily, with her, best not to take unnecessary chances. We'll take what chances we can get in all of this. Everyone, it's time.
Hey.
Fellow exiles gain enlightenment after each rite, whether they prevail or not.
Why, well, you made it, Rita. Made it all the way to the detestable pit of Malif. In doing so, of course, you have disturbed your ancient adversaries, the Withdrawn. The deranged witch who leads them has big plans in store, should she prevail in all this. Now, as you know, I normally would wish you a shameful defeat. But in this case, I wish you a little bit of luck.
The crone Udmilhe sees her companions gathered by their pyre. With a flame that shall never warm you here, must survive the night. Hear us, you slash. Make the nightmare suffer! Rookie trots forward from your ranks. Listen here, you old bag. You don't scare any of us one bit. You or your buddy slack. Now, I'm doing this or what? The question hangs in the air for longer than is comfortable. It does seem to have drawn you onto Mildy's attention, however. Rookie begins to skirm a bit. Then Mildy moves her slender fingers to her mouth. Foolish. Yes, it shall grow. His slack shall grow. His slack shall grow. He shall consume ye ere your little flame has died. That we shall ensure. And then she slides off her followers. He remains motionless for a time. Whoops.
Who shall stand together here this night? Jodariel!
Front runner! Puppy!
Rookie! Che!
Shiro-sama?
It is done!
No matter where you go, Slack shall find ye and devour ye. She's a messed up world.
Commence!
Too big.
A favorable start. The orb.
Damn it. I was trying to do the horror drop thing.
Shay plunged into the pyre. Both banished.
Well, that's unfortunate. Oof.
Quite foul for the Nightwings.
I'm screwed.
Such a display.
Ooh. That hurts.
Utmilda banished.
She missed. That was just rude.
Their flame has died a little.
A little.
A bit of a blunder.
Kidding. Really bad at passing too. I haven't got there yet. No, puppy. Oh, you're kidding.
Simply monstrous.
Oh, jeez. Where's the ball? I'm like, really? Where is it? Is it over here?
Oops, that's not what I wanted.
Oh, it's over there. How do you even pick it up? How do you even get it? It's like off the map. What the fuck? Question, how do we get the ball? The ball's in the void. They can't even reach it. Look at this.
My.
I can't get it. The ball's in the corner. I'm gonna have to, like, restart this, because I can't get it. It's right there. It's in the corner.
Oh, you poor Nightwings.
That's a problem. They're all Oh, no! I didn't anticipate from the- they didn't anticipate this. Yes, I need to load. I would see it through. I really would. But I can't. You broke it. You broke it. Good job. Okay. Well, I'm gonna continue and try that again, because... Skip this all now because we've already seen it.
Why, you made it, Frida. Made it all the way to the detestable pit of Mileath. In doing so, of course, you have disturbed your ancient adversaries, the Withdrawn. The deranged witch who leads them has big plans in store, should she prevail in all this. Now, as you know, I normally would wish you a shameful defeat. But in this case, I wish you a little bit of luck.
Soup?
Soup?
Who shall conduct this rite? Jodariel. Ruki. Shay.
Kadios?
It is done. Commence. Praise be to the scribes.
Oh, come on.
Such fervor.
He's gonna messed up.
Already does your adversary's flame begin to flicker. Somebody get the orb.
Train! Oh, jeez.
Such wherewithal. Tis taken.
Right into the center of all of the auras.
That ought to wake you up. A rude predicament for the withdrawn. 'Twas a crushing blow against their pyre.
Lifeblood of slack. It flows within this layer. Beneath this world, his lifeblood, it shall engulf thee in such blackness and despair. I got a puppy.
The witch invokes a profane name I shan't repeat. Best beware of foul sorceries.
Oh, I see. There's a thing on the ground. Oh, shit. Okay, puppy, you need to...
The orb. Resplendent.
Okay, one more hit.
The rite has nearly ended. Ouch. You have it!
This could be bad.
No law against throwing in the orb.
I'll throw your orb.
It was dangerously close.
Oh no, not again. Oh shit!
Disaster.
Oh dear.
Now take it! And it is done.
That was close.
The Nightwings once again prevail.
Nixonus!
Their adversaries confidently thwarted. The rite is done.
Would seem our adversaries failed to Enervos. See, those Bogdwellers are just a bunch of hissy talk. The scribes, they vanquished Islak, just as we prevailed to them.
Islak!
We have failed thee, and the deed shall be repaid in blood. As for ye fools, ye shall be consumed in everything around ye, from the soil to the stars. Ye shall see.
Boundless are the teachings of the scribes.
Focus, training, prowess. The path towards survival of on the blood border. These rites make similar demands of us. Ooh.
Until the stars align.
Having bested the withdrawn and solid performance, you and the others have some moments to recover from the ordeal in relative safety of the Black Wagon. So, when can we get out of here? What, Greentail? Had enough of Imelda's hospitality for the time? Oh, Jody, yeah, thanks, I'm good. The reader in the stars will point the way as ever. It's just so far, we've kept on going north. If that's the case again this time. Sea of Solas spreads north and west from here for untold leagues. I could not tell you when last a vessel dared to sail those waters.
Come, Ravens.
What's the matter, little one? Come, look outside the window. Peter, please go see what he wants. Excuse yourself and follow the imp into the dark of the night. Dark of the night, evil will find her. You find Shay and the lone minstrel already gazing up at the stars.
Magania Filifasi.
Can you not read the stars yourself then, Mr. Minstrel?
Una fortadira.
My fear is not so simple as matters of can or cannot when it comes to me, Shay. We shall see what the reader has to say, for this is her charge. And here she is, in fact. Thank you for fetching her, Tizo. You're welcome.
Ciao, venuta.
Reader, would seem the skies have cleared to some extent. Please look upon the stars and see where they compel us to go next. Someone's pouring an ice cream cone on their face. The rites beckon you still further north, toward the middle of the Sea of Solas.
Solamitan.
That's not good. You're joking, right, sister? Does the reader seem the joking type to you, Greentail? We do not argue with the stars.
You can't come back.
Talk like we can just go right out into the water. Pardon my interruption, though perhaps we can. Say what?
Tamagraje.
My client, Sandalwood, he has a way of anticipating such eventualities. West of here lies a place called Big Bertrude's. The proprietor is an old companion of his. She may be able to assist us. Some fatal have touched her and healed. Headwind's smile returns. That sounds like our best shot right now. Let's pack it up and move as soon as possible. I don't trust Headwind. He's up to something, that guy. Greetings, reader. It is good that you are here, for there is something I wish to tell you privately. Do you have a moment? I shall not keep you long, though I know your time is precious. Sure, why not? You bid him continue, and make it clear your interest in whatever he has to say. Very well, and thank you for your time. And, I should further note, matters that pertain directly to the rites I must reveal to you alone, for thus I am obliged. In any case, when you confronted the withdrawn and witch Udmilpe, you might recall she intended to evoke a certain name. Slack, the astralborn. I hesitate to say it even now. You would be forgiven if you took the ravings of Udmilpe for mere nonsense, however her words, as it turns out, ring with a certain truth. Before the union of the eight scribes, when they first found themselves here on the downside, this land was even less hospitable, if that can be believed. It was ruled over by the greater titans. The one called Islak was the eldest and most fearsome of the lot. Just the same, the scribes managed to defeat it. They later used Islak's own hide and ichor to bind the Book of Rites. However, Islak did not truly die, for by some accounts it seems to be incapable of death. The creature is regenerating even now, though very, very slowly. Its vow is to devour this land and everything in it. Only then can it return into whatever plane that banished it to ours.
Cogna Benictus.
So, in a way, it is an exile, just like you. If ever should the creature be reborn, it shall be many ages hence. Thus the ravings of Imilte are more or less inconsequential for the while. Yet the history of Islak is inexorably linked to the rites, my brain, and therefore must be known. I trust your research of the book shall lead you to discover more in time. I hope all of this is some reassurance, and now I leave you to your more immediate concerns. I shall go check to see how everyone is faring at this time. He heads out into the evening, bidding you a good rest of the evening. And with that, I'm going to sleep. Savey thing.